Trisha, and she's Yang Yang.
We are in the Gorgeous Spirits. It's on the outskirts of Jinzhou, Huanglong. Your attire doesn't seem local. Are you a roving traveler from afar, or someone returning home? Here, where you're from, or who you are.
Baijia didn't tell us you'd have these after effects when you wake up.
The wind has brought us a warning. The Atheric Sea is converging. It seems a new tacit field is taking shape.
It's probably gonna get dangerous here soon. Ugh, I knew it. Our gourds are out of service because of the Etheric Sea's influence. We can't send or receive messages for help now. We better hurry over to meet up with Baijiu at our gathering spot and get out of here. Guess you really can't recall a thing, but don't worry. If you got any questions, we can talk as we move. Yang Yang and I will give you the full scoop, every little detail from the get-go.
Rover, can we call you that for now? Before you remember your true name? We shouldn't stay here. If you don't have other plans, how about leaving with us for now?
Oh, that's great. Let's go together. Rover, I know you can't remember a thing, but there's one thing I'm 90%, no, 100% sure about you. You must be a Resonator too.
You've got a tacit mark on the back of your hand, and you have a gourd. This is proof you're a Resonator. Your gourd's design looks a bit different from the ones we use, though.
Also, we have Resonators who can detect the formation of tacit fields nearby, like what Yang Yang just did. She can tell all kind. It may seem all nice and quiet here now, but you never know when a tacit discord might pop up out of nowhere. Oh my, speak of the devil. Bravo! So you still remember how to fight despite having forgotten everything? Wow, watch me lead the charge next time. No one messes with Ma Shao Fu. Jisha.
What's wrong? Are you injured from the fight? You saw our sentinel in your memories? Yes, the one we built this statue for. The Oracle Engine Sentinel in Zhenzhou. There is one capital and six cities in Huanglong, with each city having its own sentinel. While they share some similarities in appearance, there are also differences. The sentinel in Zhenzhou is known as Jue, manifesting in the form of a long, like the statue you just saw. Sentinels are present where civilizations thrive. Huanglong stands out with the highest number of currently coexisting sentinels because of its long history and fast land. Records state the sentinels in Huanglong were once a single entity. Now they are each responsible for a part of Huanglong. Naturally, there are sentinels in other regions too, but fewer compared to Huanglong. In Huanglong, most of the sentinels take the shape of a long. In other regions, they manifest in various forms. You were standing face to face with our sentinel? One can hardly see our sentinel with their own eyes. Most people only get the chance during the appointment ceremonies. According to your description, you stood pretty close. Only the sentinel's appointed resonator is allowed in its proximity. For now, that person is the magistrate of Zhenzhou.
Whoa, darn! That must be an elite class!
Chizya might be in danger. Rover, please.
That was close. You fought so well. I didn't even get a chance to help, and Yang Yang just rushed over to protect you like a Anyway, Yang Yang was trying to shield you, and then BAM! The tacit discord was taken care of before I could get a good look!
Chizya!
Oh, by the way, speaking of Baijia, we're almost there! The place where we said we'd meet with Baijia. See? There's a resonance beacon over there! When you see a beacon, be sure to register and activate it. It's usually safe within a 5-meter radius of a beacon. It can protect you from danger sometimes.
Rover, could you hand me your terminal for a moment? Done. Its design and system version are different from ours. New terminal. Done. Done. Its design and system version are different from ours. We are almost at the gorge's entrance. There will be a descent, but if your terminal's glider module still works, it will make things easier. I will show you how to use it.
Once you're out of the gorge, there's only a short walk to reach Jinjo. Jinjo is the safest place around here. The Resonance Nexus provides coverage for the whole city. Besides, we've got a protective barrier and strong fortifications. Right?
Jinjo sits between the Deseruk Highland and the Norfolk Barrens. It's a border city and a fortress. It's very crucial to the safety of Huanglong.
Huh? We've agreed to meet up with Baizhe here. Where is she?
This is the center of the Atheric Sea.
A tacit field? When did it show up? It wasn't here when we just got here.
But I didn't sense a hint of a tacit field's presence.
So it appeared while we weren't looking? Like, in the blink of an eye? Or maybe the Etheric Sea can tell where we are. Could it be following us?
The center of the tacit field.
Isn't that Baizhe? Baizhe!
We're too far away. Perhaps she can't hear us.
We agreed to meet up around here, and she said she was off to collect some samples. Gosh, did she really go straight into the heart of a tacit field for that?
Baizhe wouldn't take such risks without careful consideration. Freshly formed tacit fields go through a dormant period. The faster a tacit field forms, the longer its dormant period lasts. For now, this tacit field should be safe.
According to the hero plays, yes, there's a chance for that.
Right. The glider can't carry us beyond the tacit field's range. Besides, Baizhe is there. We'll have to go down and see what is going on. Now it's time to use a glider module. Rover, let me help you activate it.
You are all right, it seems.
Yeah, she was super energetic. Handled a super big TD. Way more spirited than me.
I've been keeping an eye on her condition through the street. It isn't. Baizhe is just concerned about your condition. She must think we shouldn't be letting you move around that much, since you've just regained consciousness.
This isn't the place for talking. Let's go.
thing. Don't worry.
Swift and resolute.
Device every resonator has, developed by researchers in Huanglong. But you see, it's not always we get to find these. Also, there's a limit to what your gourd can absorb.
Absorption is only possible when your data bank's level is equal to or higher than the tacit discord's level. The terminal can then convert its reverberation into an echo for use in battle. My terminal issued a warning when it detected that tacit discord earlier. It should at least be an Overlord class. Rover, would you mind checking your data bank level?
No need for that. Rover, why don't you just try absorbing it with your terminal? Oh, so it doesn't work. No worries. You can start with smaller ones before tackling this guy here. There should be some sweet baby roshrooms around here. Let's go check those out, shall we?
We'll need to report the unusual phenomena here to the City Hall and the Academy. Let's make our exit.
Ability quite like this. You got any other tricks up your sleeve? Like eating a whole tacit discord? Grilling echoes alive?
Could it be related to your lost memories? Can you recall anything now? Rover, are you feeling all right? Any discomfort? Could it be the side effect of fighting that tacit discord? Baijun, Can we take Rover to do a checkup at Huashu Academy's Resonance Medical Department? Baizhi?
Absorbing echoes with the human body is not entirely unprecedented.
With a human body? I remember Comprehensive Mirror for Historians mentioned this in the Huanglong section's opening. A celestial being descended, commanding the Tiankun's boundless power. Assuming mortal form, they condensed the primordial essence, creating Pangu. Cleaving heaven and earth apart, they aligned the celestial and terrestrial. Their radiance encompassed the four corners. Thus began the illustrious annals of Huanglong, as provinces were first demarcated. If I may say, Rover, you seem quite mysterious too.
Whether it's true or not, that story happened a long time ago, when Jinjo didn't even exist. Could it be that Rover's like the great, 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 great granny of us all?
Let's not jump to conclusions without enough data and proper analysis. Rover.
Back.
This is a holographic message to all of Jinjo from the City Hall.
My fellow soldiers and citizens, I apologize for any inconvenience caused. I am Jin Shi, the Magistrate of Jinjo. As the Moon Chasing Festival approaches, our city welcomes visitors from around the world. The festivities are highly anticipated by our people, and I too share in this joyful sentiment. Jinjo has always been a crucial defense against the tacit discord outbreaks, safeguarding Huanglong. We have a heavy responsibility on our shoulders with no room for retreat or failure. It is the dedication of our warriors, along with the diligence of our citizens, that has allowed us to thrive in peace and prosperity. Despite the challenges of tacit discords, we remain steadfast and hospitable to visitors, upholding our enduring traditions. With that in mind, I have a favor to ask. Among our many visitors, there is one visitor that holds utmost importance to me, the city of Jinjo, and the entirety of Huanglong. We have awaited your arrival for a long time. Given the circumstances, you may be feeling bewildered at this time. You should have noticed some strange happenings related to you. If you plan to stay in Jinjo for some time, I would be more than delighted to personally meet you in the City Hall of Jinjo. While I cannot guarantee to provide all the answers you need, I will do my best to assist you and provide necessary permissions, if applicable. This is only my personal request. You can decide your course of action in any way you see fit. Therefore, I request the people and soldiers of Jinjo to assist this esteemed visitor when the opportunity arises.
Why do I get this feeling?
This person our magistrate was talking about
is Rover. Are you curious about our magistrate's title, Rover? Our magistrate's real name is C. Usually, the Sentinel selects a candidate during the appointment ceremony to become our magistrate. They will then take on the city's name as their surname. This signifies their wholehearted dedication to the city and its people.
Hey, that ain't the point, okay?
What are your plans now, Rover? I remember you had a flashback of yourself looking into its eyes when you saw the statue of Art Sentinel. We can't confirm its authenticity, but based on the Magistrate's message, it seems Qinzhou has a lot to do with your past. Whether you were the visitor our Magistrate mentioned or not, he was surely important to Qinzhou, and you will be our important...
Friend! We've already entrusted our lives to each other. I've never seen so many TDs packed together, and that elite one was so scary. Well, you did get rid of most of them. Anyway, once we're back in Qinzhou, I'll treat you to that famous specialty from Panhua's restaurant.
It would be best for your well-being to have a thorough physical examination once we arrive in Qinzhou. While there don't seem to be any immediate side effects following the absorption of that echo...
I'm gonna get you one you can absorb! I never go back on my promise! Your hero Qixia's on the hunt!
Let me be your blade.
Can you reenact what you did before?
Maybe you can only absorb the powerful ones with your body. Or does it have to be a certain type of tacit discord? Or maybe... Maybe we should give your terminal a whirl. Yay! It worked! Yay! Your terminal's got a different look. But the functions are pretty much the same. City's just up ahead.
Rover?
There you are,
my dearest seed of fate.
Alrighty, what should we do next? Shall we go grab a bite?
I am to return to the Academy. The anomalies of the Gorges of Spirits, the resurgence of that tacit field, and the many wave-worn phenomena occurrences. I should report them in time.
Then I'll go submit our report and prepare the documentation needed for Rover's audience with the Magistrate while I'm there.
Then I guess I'll take Rover over to the Nexus Tower for registration first, and we'll just hang out for a while. Being new to Qinzhou and all, she can't be left standing outside the city hall with nothing to do. Hospitality is our local specialty, you know.
Then, I'll leave you in Shizye's care, Rover. Is that all right with you? I'll give you a call once the paperwork is done.
Leave it to me!
I'll send the branch of Resin Medical Science a notice. We need to conduct a thorough fit. Come visit the Academy after your audience if you have no other plans.
You guys done yet? What's the holdup? Let's move! Then I'll have more time to show Rover around. We've got loads. loads of fun in Jinjo. We can go watch lion dances, hero plays, stand-up shows, and then maybe the martial championships. Plus tons of different treats to try out. You think it, we have it. Chissa, ally of justice, at your service. Are you the one in need of a hero? Here we are, Jinjo's Nexus Tower. Exactly. Let me see, think of it as Jinjo's largest service station, or an integration hub. It's something along those lines. I'm not much of a tech person myself. Long story short, it's a navigator, a defense system, and a regional information center all in one enormous package. The smaller ones we ran into earlier are resonance beacons. Data is shared between all beacons. You activate one, and the entire map's data will be relayed to your terminal. Pretty nifty, huh? Just place your terminal here. I'll fire it up!
Arrangements in place. Rover, you can come visit the magistrate at any time. Chissa, do you mind bringing Rover over to the city hall?
Go see for yourself! Everyone's...
Ew! First time seeing such a crowd in front of the city hall!
I was surprised too. I've never seen so many non-staff personnel here before. Most of the people here have applied for an audience, but I heard they've all been turned down.
So this is the true confidence of our rover. I agree, though. So far, you've been ticking all the boxes in our magistrate's description. Sure it can.
Have you thought of something, Rover? You mean... I can't really keep up with your thoughts, but I think a meeting with a magistrate wouldn't hurt.
Same here. Anyway, our magistrate's the best lead we have for now, no matter what she has in store for Rover.
What do you think, Rover? Are you in a hurry to recover your memories? In that case, how about meeting with a magistrate first? She may have the answers you're looking for. not allowed to go with you. Shizia and I will be right outside the city hall. We'll be waiting for you.
That's right. We're not going anywhere. Just give us a shout if anything goes down. Wait, no, we won't be able to hear you. Plus, they've got this rule about not yelling inside the city hall.
Follow me. Kindly have a seat. Lady Sanhua will be with you shortly. Pleased to make your acquaintance. I apologize for the delay. My name is Sanhua, the bodyguard of Madame Magistrate. I regret to inform you that Madame Magistrate is currently away. Prior to her departure, she instructed me to bring you these tokens and a welcome gift. Madame Magistrate advised you to explore what these tokens represent during her absence. This may help you acquire the information you desire sooner. I apologize for the inconvenience, but please rest assured she will be here to meet you in 3 days' time. Since Madame Magistrate is currently away, I cannot make the final confirmation on her behalf. But you are truly exceptional. Regarding that, my eyes can see the frequencies of all living beings. Or rather, those frequencies are the only thing I can see. You share the same frequency with Madame Magistrate. Apologies, my description was not accurate. Both you and Madame Magistrate look undistorted to me. In my eyes, you appear the way you are. They all look different. May I have your terminal for a moment? Yes, it's the gourd on your waist. The device every resonator carries. Madame Magistrate thought you might need it. The utility module on your terminal has been upgraded to the latest iteration. Now, all the utilities, including sensor, you are now granted unlimited access to all regions in Jinzhou. I have sent your terminal ID to every border pass and residence beacon. You will only need to display your terminal ID or activate a beacon with your terminal for entry. You are free to visit any part of Jinjo. Yes, including the City Hall. You have full access to its facilities. Also, may I ask, have you decided your place of residence in Jinjo? If not, Madam Magistrate has arranged accommodation for you in advance, here in the City Hall. I will lead you to your room if you need. Understood. We will be ready to accommodate you anytime. Anything I can help you with, Rover? With pleasure. What do you wish to know about Jinjo? The Midnight Rangers, under General Jian's command, are a garrison in Jinjo. They consist of the vanguards for offensive operations. Again, additionally, there is a detachment unit called the Outriders, mostly made up of volunteers or reservists who serve as reconnaissance agents. Most of the servicemen of today are comprised of Resonators. With pleasure. What do you wish to know about Jinjo? Jinjo is not the most populated city in Huanglong. As a border city, it is the front line encountering tacit discord outbreaks. Jinjo holds a special place in my heart. I can't say I am too familiar with my hometown, but I do feel a homely sense of attachment to Jinjo. Maybe it's because here lives a person who changed my life. If I were to introduce Jinjo with my own words, I'd say it's a city one would easily grow attached to. With pleasure. What do you wish to know about Jinjo? Anything I can help you with, Rover? Of course. Please feel free to ask me anything. Our magistrate's birth name was Si. She took on the name Jinsi when she became the magistrate of Jinjo. Nowadays, she is usually addressed as Madam Magistrate. Of course. Please feel free to ask me anything. She is also known as the Loom Maiden because of her resonance connection with our sentinel, Jue, who manifests in the shape of a loom. The ways Huanglong's magistrates interact with their corresponding sentinels can differ. In Jinjo, our magistrate seems to share a familial bond with the sentinel. Though this is what I understand from what she has told me. I have only seen our sentinel a handful of times, of course. Please feel free. It depends on Madam Magistrate, and it depends on your decision, Rover. Please pardon me. This is all I can say at the moment, of course. Anything I can help you with, Rover? With pleasure. I suggest looking into where these tokens come from, examine their locations of origin, and explore the sites or past events they represent. Then you should uncover the message Madam Magistrate wanted to convey, and hopefully learn everything you want to know. With pleasure. What do you wish to know? Of course, it is fully up to you. With pleasure. Anything I can help you with, Rover? Of course. I'm afraid not. I have never seen you before. If I had, I would never forget you. Anything I can help you with, Rover?
Rover! It took you
so long? What gives? Was our magistrate a chatterbox? So Madam Magistrate's not in the City Hall. It sure is.
Shizia, the increasing tacit fields, uncannily powerful tacit discords, and now, our Magistrate's absence.
Plus, the mysterious rover.
I'm afraid.
Well, we've reported to the City Hall, the Ministry of War, and the Academy. We've done everything we can. I mean, this is one long, and we're talking about Jinjo of all places. We've been through our fair share of unrest over the past 1,000 years, and we've made it together every time. There's been TD outbreaks every year, but we can always trust General Ji Yan, Madam Magistrate, and our Sentinel to have our backs. We're not ones to mess with.
United we stand, a bastion of might. One equal the Legion, invulnerable in fight. Well said, Chizya. Do you have any plans, Rover?
Fair point. A 3-day vacation it is. Let's go chill out then. We'll figure out the tokens when we have the chance. Ooh, reminds me of the tokens of love in those stories. It sounds like you're off to a secret date or something. What is our magistrate planning to do with these token puzzles? Soulmate?
So, Madam Magistrate left some hidden clues in her tokens. Clues that only the right person would be able to decipher. But Rover has lost all memories and would likely forget any kind of decryption method they agreed on. It doesn't quite make sense. Or maybe she is trying to make Rover notice something else. Rover, do you mind if we have a look at the tokens?
So, what's so special about them? A candy? Oh, I've had these when I was a kid. I think they were called sugar pearls, but I haven't seen anything like this in a while. Went out of trend, maybe.
It reminds me of I was really scared of getting my flu shots when I was little. And sometimes the nurse lady would hand out candies like this as a prize for being good. But what does it mean as a token? It seems like a miniature sundial. It is a horological device that tells time by using sunlight's direction. Sundials in Huanglong usually have marked lines for the 12 shichuns in a day. And every shichun is 2 hours long, with some showing seasons or months. The design of this sundial looks a bit unusual, though. On this sundial, time seems to be represented by the 12 earthly branches drawn on the outer ring of its surface. And its inner ring shows the 4 symbols, each representing one cardinal direction. These are the 4 famous auspicious beasts in Huanglong's folklore. They are believed to protect people from all 4 directions under heaven. Generally, the teal long represents the east. The white tiger stands for the west. The vermilion bird stands for the south. And finally, we have the black tortoise for the north. It seems this sundial is supposed to show both time and direction. But how could it work when there is not a compass attached? Not to mention, the lack of sunlight basically renders it useless.
Ugh, that requires way too much brain power. The color of this leaf seems a bit odd. Can't tell what tree it is.
I think I can feel something from it. Never mind. It's too faint. Maybe it was just my imagination. Sorry. I can't tell what kind of tree this leaf belongs to either. This is a mangosteen fruit. Mangosteens are not native to Zhengzhou. They are usually imported by boat. I think we can find more mangosteens being sold at the nearby markets. They're not always available for purchase, though. The frequent tacit discord outbreaks can disrupt transportation and cause shortages. The Midnight Rangers have greatly improved the situation in recent years, but still. So Jizya and I share similar childhood memories of the Sugar Pearl. Do you remember it too, Rover?
When it comes to candies, no one knows them better than the kids of Zhengzhou. There's still some distance to the Huashu Academy. Let's see who reaches there faster. Yang Yang just installed some apps for you, remember? Just look for the one that's called Utilities on the terminal. See? Just open the Utilities, select the grapple, and there you go. See? See? Just open the utilities, select the grapple, and there you go. See? Just open the utilities, select the grapple, and there you go. If you want to be a hero like the Zhengzhou Speedster, you gotta master the grapple. Come on, give it a shot, Rover. Wait a sec, someone's looking for me, yeah? What? When did he disappear? Don't worry, it's all right, I'll be right there. Duty calls! Oops, almost forgot. Can't be late. Sorry, Rover, Yang Yang. I've gotta head off for my shift. I'll join you right after I'm done, all right? If you need me, just shout my name, and I, the Zhengzhou Speedster, will be there in a sec. Stop! Stop! Don't call me that! Anyway, I gotta go. You guys okay on your own? Give me a heads up when there's any updates.
Sure. Go do your thing. Don't worry. I'm staying with him. Rover, let's go inside. To my message. She's probably busy in her lab. Over there must be Mr. Mortify from the Department of Safety. Baizhi once mentioned him before. He might be able to help us get in touch with Baizhi, but it seems we've caught him at a bad time.
The previous prototype almost met one.
Anyway, let's try asking him, shall we?
What? You need something?
Mr. Mortify, please pardon our intrusion. We are friends of Baizhi, and we're here to look for her.
I see. I hope I didn't cause any offense earlier.
Not at all. It was us who bothered you.
Baizhi should be in the data analysis room. I'll go tell her you're here.
Thank you, sir. This is Mortify, a renowned figure in the Department of Safety. He was born in the New Federation, and he joined the Huashu Academy a few years ago. I heard his talent is truly impressive. People say he's a bit scary at first glance, but he's actually quite kind-hearted once you get to know him. Shizya told me he's quite popular with the kids. Children have been pestering him for all kinds of fancy toys, and he's always open to their requests.
Here you are. The data we collected in the Gorges of Spirits has been submitted for analysis, and we'll have the results today. I have the equipment for your physical examinations ready too. Any discoveries during your trip to the City Hall?
What do you think, Baizhi?
I have a hypothesis about the Sugar Pearl, but I need to verify it first. If possible, I recommend conducting non-destructive tests of all these tokens you have. Data is always straightforward. The first three tokens can be tested at my branch's laboratory. This miniature sundial will require radiographic testing, though. To access the necessary equipment, we'll need to file a request with one of the Tacitite Studies-related branches. Indeed. One moment, please.
Give me the items to be tested. Anything else you need me to know, you can let me know now. You may retrieve your items in 20 minutes, and the analysis report will be ready 5 minutes after that. Take a right, and you'll find me in the testing room. This one looks like the early handiwork of someone I know. It's lightweight, and its design differs from that of the typical sundial. And it appears to be missing a part. See? There's a groove here.
It will take some time before the results are ready. If you have other matters to take care of, you should go ahead. I'll let you know once we have the results.
Shall we wait here at the academy? Over?
Sure you can. But don't forget your physical examination. I'll see you in a while for that. I'll need to check your health status and see if there are any unusual fluctuations. Now let's begin, if you're ready. Do you have any questions before we begin? Apart from the ancient legend Yang Yang mentioned earlier, I've never heard of anything like this. But if we look at it another way, we might finally be able to verify said legend. Once we figure out what really happened with your body. Now let's begin, if you're ready. Can you try to manifest the Crownless's frequency without using your terminal? I am not seeing the Crownless's data in your terminal. So it was indeed absorbed into your body. The Crownless's frequency energy was consumed by your body, leaving no trace behind. But how did you manage to do that? It's as though there's another mechanism within your body capable of absorbing frequency energy. I can't say without sufficient data. To put it simply, it seems there is another dimension or a creature hiding inside your body. A universe. That's a poetic and intriguing comparison. It seems we need a simulated combat to figure out what happened in your body. Please hold your terminal tight and stay still. Academy's simulated training ground. Don't worry, Yang Yang and I will assist you. Please fight the simulated tacit discords like you normally would.
One with the sound.
As your body previously detected, your body functions are in good condition. And you seem entirely unaffected by the Crownless's energy. We will temporarily boost your resonance for further testing.
Zephyrin!
Not the slightest fluctuation in your frequency energy. So it is not your resonance ability. We'll do another round to fully test your condition. We have gathered all the data we need. The test is ending soon. Rover, you can find the exit straight up ahead.
Rover, can you hear me? Hello?
The comm line is dead. Something's wrong. Gotta be cautious. Now, where is the exit? I'm back to the same spot again. And this moon? What is happening? Are those tacit discords?
Rover, do you still remember what you saw? Can you give us some more details? A giant tacit discord with a scythe. It doesn't sound like the Crownless. Might be even higher ranked. This is the first time we've run into anything like this since we put the training ground into use. The Sonoro Sphere captures everything that once happened in a specific time and place, be it good or bad. We built this simulated training ground after the structure of Sonoro Spheres. Our goal was to extract pure remnant energy with the simulated Sonoro Sphere. But we cannot guarantee that all abnormal frequencies were eliminated. Your arrival may have revived the abnormal frequencies we accidentally captured. Remnant energy sometimes gives rise to memory manifestations of sentient beings. You may have encountered one such manifestation. I suspect it could have something to do with your unconscious mind. Such anomalies could have been hiding in the simulation, and they resonated with your subconscious. Or perhaps they were lifted from your subconscious in the first place. I'm afraid I can't give you a conclusion yet. Not until we've run a thorough analysis on the data collected. I'll also check the simulated sonorosphere again to see what on earth happened to it. In terms of bodily functions, you seem to be in perfect health. In fact, all the data look quite good. But if you feel anything unusual, please come find me anytime.
Here's your sundial, intact as it was.
Mr. Mordvey, can we have the test results?
Simply put, it's hollow. Here, try tapping on it. It sounds different from a solid object. It's not just a timekeeping tool. It's an intricate mortise and tenon puzzle box. This sundial is hollow with an inner compartment. We've scanned it, and there is a small paper scroll inside. However, it's missing a crucial component. We should be able to spin the wheels on the sundial once the right component is installed. I have some basic knowledge, but there is someone else who is more knowledgeable in automata mechanics than I am. It wouldn't have taken me this long if we were dealing with Tacitite weapons. Install the missing part, then rotate the wheels to their correct positions, and you should be able to solve the puzzle and access the paper scroll. However, I still have no idea what the missing component should look like. And no need to ask him. I can help you with this. I just need some time to think it over. One moment. I have an incoming call. What is it? You certainly are well informed. It's indeed beautiful data. Good taste. Well, since you've put it that way.
Rover, Mr. Mordvey's expression seems to have softened, don't you think? An amiable person, isn't he? We haven't even asked him to help us with assembling. It looks like Mr. Mordvey needs more time. Maybe we should give him some space to concentrate. Rover, let's come back later, shall we?
Yes, of course. I've already noticed all that you mentioned. Indeed, you just pointed out a blind spot in my thinking. Your workshop? That hellish place? Stop sweet-talking me. I get it. Sorry for keeping you waiting. Let's get back to the sundial. It's a mortise and tenon-based puzzle box. The missing component in the middle needs to fulfill two entirely different structural requirements at the same time. Considering its entire structure, this component needs an automatic buckle that goes down on top of an embedded pointer. I'll draw up a design for you. The parts you'll need can be found in Jiang Li's workshop. I've already informed him about it. You'll only need to go fetch the parts in his place. He keeps a box full of them.
This This should be it. It's quite a box full. Let's go back and show it to Mr. Mortify. Mr. Mortify? We found the parts.
Good. Bring it to me.
The test results are in. The mangosteen is just an ordinary fruit. It's suitable for regular consumption. We found nothing unusual about it. From the purple leaf you presented, I detected subtle fluctuations in tacit discord's frequency from two distinct sources, but they were overlapping and difficult to distinguish. This is a rare occurrence. The scattered nature of these fluctuations rules out the possibility of them being left behind through contact. This is not an ordinary leaf, but it doesn't seem to be a tacit discord either. Based on the data we gathered, I believe it was sampled from an area struck with the wave-worn phenomena.
Yes, the anomalies that occurred after the lament, including the formation of tacit fields, etheric sea, retroact rain, and gravity loss. These are collectively called the wave-worn phenomena. And the lament was the start of it all.
As for the sugar pearl, it has been determined to be a type of oral vaccine. This sugar pearl expired over 20 years ago. The low temperature storage life for this vaccine is about 2 years.
A 20-year-old vaccine. Could it be related to the children's epidemic in Zhengzhou 2 decades ago?
The archives in the Academy should have information on the sugar pearl. The archives here are organized in a unique way. You can start by searching the keywords at the lobby terminal.
Mr. Mortify?
The missing pointer has been installed, and now the sundial should be complete.
So, the discs are rotatable now?
Yes. Align the correct markers with the pointer we just installed, and then you should be able to open it.
The earthly branches and four symbols. These symbols are related to the sexagenary cycle. It's an intricate way of recording time in Huanglong. Nowadays, it is mainly reserved for calendars, numerology, and indexing. But it's falling out of daily use. Now, what kind of information could it represent?
It's the filing system. Most of Huanglong's libraries and databases still use this method to organize their archives, namely the Grand Libraries.
Yes, the large data repositories located in Huanglong's major cities.
The Academy's public archives are organized in this manner too.
Located on the way shelf. Mao, Cheng, Si, Gu, Wei. Grover, it's here! here. Huh. If I remember correctly, Genjo was established during a year of Wei, several cycles ago. The Genjo City Hall and Huashu Academy were built in the same year. The Gorges of Spirits battle sparked Genjo's founding, and the formidable tacit discord described here? I believe it is the Crownless. Rover, about the Sugar Pearl. What do you think, Rover? I've only seen our magistrate once at the appointment ceremony, so I can't comment on her personality, but her policies have proven effective and greatly benefited us since she took office. Some believe that the remarkably far-sighted and profound decisions were actually devised by Counselor Chang Li due to the young age of the magistrate. You seem to hold Madam Magistrate in high regard.
Let's look back on what we've gathered so far. Our clues point to the Sugar Pearl as a key in solving the Sundial's puzzle. Simply put, one token can lead to multiple targets, and one target may hold several pieces of information. We both had a reason for meeting. The magistrate had information to share, while I had questions to ask. However, her tokens contain both what she wants to tell me and what I want to ask her, making it seem like she is complicating matters. Maybe she was running out of time. That's why she could only offer us scraps of the puzzle instead of actually putting it together. Or perhaps she's indeed a master strategist, leaving breadcrumbs for us to follow. The initial clues may simply be a test to. She needed to ensure that those who may come across these tokens without understanding their true meaning would not be able to use them for access. If it were you, Yang Yang, what would you do to make sure the recipient gets what you mean?
I would emphasize my true message by repeating it again and again.
How's it going, Rover? Feeling spry as ever?
Baijiu said he is in great health. No issues to report. We made some progress in investigating the tokens, too.
Nothing special. A typical patrol. Well, Uncle Chang's cat climbed a tree, and on its way down, it landed on Uncle Chempi's head, causing him to take a tumble. Some dogs kept barking and have been scaring the passers-by. So I received a report about someone going missing. I just logged the case and talked to the person who reported it. You're not the one they're searching for, though. Anyhow, I need to visit the person who reported the case tomorrow. Oh, I also tried searching for Rover's terminal number, but the system came up with nothing. The latest record was from today when I took Rover for registration. That's pretty much the update for now. You betcha. All right, I still owe you a meal. The night markets are closed, though. Let's grab breakfast at Panhua's restaurant tomorrow before my shift. Meet you guys there in the morning. Be there or be square.
Do you have a place to stay, Rover?
Talk about hospitality. Boy, I wonder what it's like to live in the City Hall. All right, enough chatter or the sun's gonna come up. Let's get Rover back to the City Hall and we'll leave the rest till tomorrow.